I flipped my Voron Trident upside down. Let's check out the differences in performance, printing and more. Nonsense? Possibly, but let's investigate and find out. What's not nonsense is the message of today's sponsor, NordVPN. Click the link below to benefit from a huge discount because it is NordVPN's 10th birthday. Just like I value speed and quality at 3D printing, NordVPN values speed and quality in their VPN services. I might have had a quick try in other services, but for me, NordVPN is the service I stick to for years now as it just works. What I love most about NordVPN is its quick installation and how easy it is to set up your preferences. I dig that intuitive user interface that allows you to switch servers and to enable features with just a few easy clicks. With NordVPN's threat protection feature, you won't have to worry about malware or harmful sites anymore. Signing up to NordVPN is risk-free as well, as you get a 30-day money-back guarantee on all purchases. I am happy about this collaboration, as you can seize the opportunity of NordVPN's 10th birthday celebration. Use my link or code below to get into trusted NordVPN browsing. Not like a caveman. While building my Voron Trident 250 from an Elio kit, which were thankfully provided by my friend Jason, I simply put it upside down to finish the electronics more conveniently. While watching the first movements and homing at this stance, I thought about printer concepts which are meant to be quote-unquote upside down. For instance, the Positron by Krellin 3D. The tool head is upside down and the bed is moving upwards. Here, the inversion is an essential part of the concept, as it is meant to be foldable to the size of a filament spool box. Another example is the Sota by Kokoni. It has its motion system located at the bottom with the nozzle pointing upwards as well. The bed is moving from bottom to top while stacking the layers. With most of the electronics and the motion system situated at the base, both static and dynamic masses are concentrated at a low height relative to the printer's stance. The default setup of the Trident is deferring to this. Electronics are concentrated at the bottom, but the motion system operates at a significant height. This might be unfavorable concerning vibrations and stability in comparison to concepts like the Positron or the Sota. So, I wanted to check out, pun intended, what are the ups and downs for going upside down with a Voron Trident? Which impacts are there on its resonances for input shaping? Can we see a difference while regular printing? Does this improve on overhang performance, maybe on bridging and its general usability? Let's just do that and find out. I saw two options for going upside down. The easiest and most obvious option, just turn it around. The more intense option, relocate all electronics, including the whole wiring, from bottom to top, and then turning it around. A complete relocation of the electronics is huge efforts to start with on my new and so far nicely working Trident build. So I opted for option 1, as it is a rather effortless and quick way to make a first check on resonances, printing and other effects arising on using a Trident upside down. I wanted my Trident to stand securely on the same feet as on its regular stance. I made a quick design which replaces the corner clips of the top panel using the original feet for the new stance. Super easy to do, and you'll find the link to the STL in the video description if you want to try this by yourself. One important note though, the default nozzle set homing does not work anymore as the used shaft falls out of the assembly when upside down. I simply went homing with the inductive probe, which works, but accuracy suffers. I was super curious about the results for input shaping at the upside down stance, so I started with measuring the resonances for both stances. By the way, this is one part where the LDO kits for Voron printers shine. They include the Inputshaper toolkit, which makes the measurements with the ADXL345 really easy to assemble, to configure and to perform. Both measurements were taken at the same spot on the shelf inside my printing room. The results for the default stance already came out well. Despite that little additional peak here at around 60 Hz, the x-axis looks nice as far as I can judge. There is one pronounced peak, and with the MZV shaper applied at around 72 Hz, the remaining vibrations and the resulting smoothing seems to be just fine for the x-axis at up to around 50 km/s². I would not go deeper into optimization with a result like this, but I am by far no expert in vibration, resonances and resonance compensation. What's your thoughts on these graphs? The results for the y-axis look quite good for my taste too. One pointed peak and the recommended favorable MZ V-shaper seems to be able to do a rather good job at muting vibrations. Though I am not sure about the recommended maximum acceleration here, as it's even higher than for the X-axis. Anyways, we can leave it like this for a delta comparison to the upside down stance. Putting the Trident upside down and redoing the measurements shows interesting differences. On the X-axis, the graph is significantly more pointed and narrower in comparison to the regular stance. In addition, the peak for the power spectral density is higher than at default. Being upside down, we have a more forceful response from the system at its resonance. Also, that additional little peak we've seen at default at around 60 Hz is not existent anymore. It seems flattened now. As the graph for upside down is pointed and narrow, the ZV shaper seems to be a good choice for reducing vibrations for this setup. Also worth noting, the noise coming from all the other axes seems to be flattened at upside down stance. However, be aware, the Y scale for power density has increased by one order of magnitude. The Y-axis shows the same behavior. The graph is more pointed and narrower, higher maximum for the power spectral density, therefore noise from the other axis seem flattened, and ZV shaper is applicable. Summed up, even though there are interesting differences between both stances concerning the measured resonances, I doubt that upside down would be considerably faster at same quality compared to default stance. So I just used the Trident default settings in Orca Slicer for the prints I made to compare both stances. First, the 3D Banshee to get an overview. The Autodesk FDM test, which includes bridging, overhangs and more. I also went into extreme bridging to see if we'll profit from turning around gravity. The Banshee came out nicely at both stances and at default Orca Slicer settings for the Trident. It's hard to spot a difference anywhere on it. Maybe the bridges are a tad less saggy on the Banshee printed upside down. Same results on the Autodesk FDM tests. The overhang part, the bridging and everything else is almost identical. There is near to zero advantage for upside down. Though I still wanted to check out extreme bridging anyways and designed some very long bridges up to 225 mm in length. I was curious to see what happens there at reverse gravity. Admittedly, that's a very synthetic scenario which no one would apply in real life printing. You'll find the link in the video description. First of all, I was surprised that the longer bridge tests didn't end up in spaghetti for both stances. The Trident was even able to print the numbers on all test lengths, but there is zero advantage for the upside down stance. Though a bridging length up to 75 mm seems to be viable with some optimization. As a reference, I also tried this test on my X1 Carbon sliced in bamboo slicer. And I realized that the X1 Carbon performed noticeably better than the Trident. The top layer is fairly okay up to around 100 to 125 mm of bridging length. Without going deeper into this rabbit hole, I speculate that better tweaking for bridging and probably the additional external part cooling fan of the X1 Carbon might make that difference. In the end, I assume that good performance in extreme bridging additionally is a topic of the thermal balance between nozzle and bed too. As I tried something, I tried to stack the bridges on a vertical test print, mostly because it was better for filming and showing what happens when performing extremely long bridges. First, I tried it on the X1 Carbon. Surprisingly, it performed way worse than at the horizontal test, with the only difference being the heated bed at higher distance to the bridge because of the stacked fashion. Quite the same result on the upside down Trident. The bridging fails earlier than on a horizontal arrangement. I didn't repeat this test on the default stance because there wasn't a surprise to expect here, because this isn't an extreme bridging video and because the results are clear. To tackle the question from the beginning, is upside down printing nonsense? Kind of, but it depends. Functionally, I can't find a good reason for this. Maybe it could help to keep a printer at high speeds and acceleration and on the wonky table a bit more stable. If I would try to desperately find positives for upside down, concerning the Trident, it might be a bit more convenient to have the screen at eye level, like on the Bambolet P1 or X1 printers. Also, having the electronics accessible more conveniently at the top might be a pro for upside down. For everything else, not really favorable. Observing prints at upside down stands is inconvenient, taking off the build plate with the finished prints is weird, and all the debris falling at the hot end isn't beneficial at all. As the Positron is a very small, foldable and unique machine, I wouldn't dare to judge on its upside down fashion. As I said before, it's an essential part of the concept. Concerning the Kokoni Sota, oh man, they still need to prove that this whole campaign isn't just a big scam. Please check out Uncle Chess's video on this topic. The Trident and almost all other cubed printers are okay as they are. Or did I miss something? Please share your thoughts in the comments. Like, share, subscribe and ring the bell if you like that quick excursion to upside down printing. See you on the next one. Servus und goodbye.